By end of this video, you'll not just know what intentions are, but learn a simple yet powerful way of manifesting it in your life. Keep watching. Hey there, I'm Aparna, your personal coach, helping you upskill yourself to lead the life you desire. Now, last week we spoke about how intentions are core to everything that you do. Today's questions are actually part of last week's questions, and they border around intentions and how you can manifest intentions in your life. But before I get to the question, let us understand and be very, very clear as to what intentions are. By definition, intentions are conceptions of mind that are formed by directing our mind towards an object. Let me tell you a story. When my son was around 5 years old, he had an accident in the shower. It was late evening on a hot summer day, and I know he was enjoying his shower because he was humming a recently learned nursery rhyme. Suddenly, I hear a thud and a cry. I rush to see that he had fallen, and the corner of the bucket had given him a deep gash. I pick him up, I wash his wound, and I take him to the hospital, and he has 7 stitches at the back of his head, which is the nape. Very, very sensitive area. Looking back, I remember there was nothing that was going through in my mind. I had no panic, no anxiety attack, no negative thoughts or stories. I had an absolute clarity that he is going to be all right, and I am going to take him to the hospital and get the stitches that are required. And that clarity in my mind had pushed me to drive him to the hospital by myself without any help, with my bleeding son in my lap. The point of the story is just that, absolute clarity. Absolute clarity mixed with action will always give you the best result. And that's exactly what intention is. You could be having a lot of talents, but if you do not have the clarity on how you're going to maximize those talents, then you will not get any result. Often I hear complaints such as, I intended to do this, I intended to do that, but it never happened. True intention is being so clear as to what you want. It's as if the blinders are lifted off and you can see the path, your action plan, or even the next step that you need to take very, very clearly in your mind. So we can safely say that intentions are the starting point to every single dream. It's that creative fuel that fulfills all our needs and desires, whether it is money, relationships, spirituality, and even love. When I began to work on my intentions and to experiment the laws of attraction, this is the first question I got. What is the difference between goals and intentions? Well, goals, I found, are future forward. They are the destination. It's your external achievement. Whereas intentions are something that you live in the current present moment. It's lived each day, independent to whether you're reaching the goal or no. It is the inner relationship that you have with yourself and with others. So if your goal is to run a marathon, the intention is to show up at the start line. It's what we choose to do regardless of external forces. So the question I have today is from a friend who does not want to be named. He says, hey Aparna, you're aware I set goals in my life, but somehow in spite of trying hard, I am failing at them. You mentioned intentions the last time we spoke. So my question to you is, how can I create intentions in my life? Can you please give me a simple solution? Well, there are many ways to create your intentions. What I found working for me is to question myself at every single point in time. For example, every morning I question myself, how do I want to feel after this workout? I question myself, what is it that I want to achieve from this meeting? Why am I really doing this activity? What does this mean to me? Use whatever questions that come naturally to you. And you can actually use this technique in any area of your life, any area that you want to be transformed, any area that you want to be fixed. And once the question is ready, then you listen to your answer. There's a little voice in all our heads, right, that tells you what you are supposed to do or what is the real solution. Just listen to it. Don't dismiss the solution just because it sounds so simple or it sounds stupid. Actively listen to what it says. And if there are multiple solutions, multiple answers, then you narrow it down to that one answer that suits you best. Then you connect that intention to your daily activity, the action step that you take, regardless to what your situation is. Staying with the example that I cited earlier, if your goal is to run 5-kilometer marathon, then preparing to run, having proper nutrition, waking up early, and showing up at the start line are all the actionable items that are fueled by your intention to run. So there you are, three steps to create your intentions. You question yourself at every given point in time, find your why, listen actively to your answers, the answer that your little voice in your head tells you, your intuition, your gut feel, whatever that talks back to you. And lastly, connecting your intention to your emotion and your daily activity. Three steps to create intentions in your life. I hope that's simplistic enough for you. The worst thing that you can do to yourself is to waste your life. So I urge you to commit yourself to living intentionally and on purpose. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful time. I'll see you next week. If you have any suggestions, questions, feedback, or thoughts about intentional living or today's video, do leave it in the comment section below or reach out to me in any of the social media platforms I am in. If you have more information about my work or have an intention to work with me, do head to my website. The details are also given in the description below. If you find this video resourceful, do hit a like button, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Subscribe and also hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update from me.